temporary home to some Afghan refugees, with thousands more to come very soon.
CBS 4's Eric Graves went to the base today to look into how the process is working and hear reaction from local lawmakers.
I think Hoosier hospitality is paramount.
Representative Andre Carson says Indiana will be a leader for what resettlement looks like for the thousands of Afghans coming to the U.S. The first Afghans arrived Thursday to the Indianapolis airport. These pictures from the National Guard show refugees' first steps on American soil and where they'll be staying at Atterbury. State Senator Fadi Kudura says this is a great opportunity for Indiana.
And our nation is a nation of immigrants, and we succeed by welcoming more people.
Both Kudura and Carson say they're looking for any way their offices can help. Carson says volunteers will play a large part in helping the refugees.
You know, the NGOs and nonprofits will have a lot of heavy lifting as it relates to this and folks transitioning back into society.
We do know the Red Cross is helping to welcome Afghans to Indiana. We've been told that 8 volunteers have been allowed to go into Atterbury and provide humanitarian aid to the refugees. Even today, we've seen a few Red Cross cars coming and going.
This isn't about politics. It's about treating people with kindness and respect.
To those unsure about these allies coming to Indiana and America, Kudura hopes you'll reconsider.
I appeal to their humanity. I appeal to their compassion. I appeal to the values that drive them.
An immigrant himself, Kudura says the process of rebuilding your life in a new country is not an easy journey.
It is a very difficult process. And it takes a lot of love and compassion from strangers, from government, from nonprofits to make that journey just a little bit easier.
In Johnson County, Eric Graves, CBS 4 News.
Eric, thank you. As for when the next plane of refugees will arrive, we don't know yet. Those plans are being kept a secret. We do know that several area nonprofits like Exodus Refugee Immigration and the United Way are standing by to help as they can.